हेलो, दिस इज सौरभ कुमार फ्रॉम अ स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम आई एम त्रिची, रोल नंबर 2001152. एंड द टॉपिक आई एम गोना टॉक अबाउट टुडे इज इंपैक्ट ऑफ पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ ऑन इंडियाज इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट. सो द पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ हैज हैम्पर्ड द इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन मेनी वेज. फर्स्ट, ओवर यूज ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. रैपिड पॉपुलेशन ग्रोथ टेंड्स टू ओवर यूज द कंट्रीज नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. दिस इज पर्टिकुलरली द केस वेर द मेजोरिटी ऑफ पीपल आर डिपेंडेंट ऑन एग्रीकल्चर फॉर देयर लाइवलीहुड. With rapidly increasing population, agriculture holding becomes smaller and unremunerative to cultivate. There's no possibility of increasing farm production through the use of new land. Consequently, many households continue to live in poverty. In fact, the population of India has increased from 102 crores in 2001 to 121 crores in 2011, which leads to the overuse of land, thereby endangering the welfare of future generations. Second, per capita income. The population growth on per capita income is unfavorable. The growth of population tends to retard the per capita income in mainly three ways. It increases the pressure of population on land. It leads to increase in cost of consumption goods because of the scarcity of the cooperant factor to increase their supplies. It leads to a decline in accumulation of capital because with increase in family members, expenses increase. These adverse effects of population growth on per capita income operate more severely if the percentage of children in a total population is high. Therefore, a large number of children in the population entail a heavy burden on economy because these children simply consume and don't add to the national product. Third, agricultural development. In underdeveloped countries like India, people mostly live in rural areas. Agriculture is their main occupation. So with population growth, the land-man ratio is distributed. Pressure of population on land rises because land supply is inelastic. It adds to the disguised unemployment and reduced per capita productivity further. As the number of landless workers increase, the wages fall. Thus, low per capita productivity reduces the propensity to save and invest. As a result, the use of improved technology and other improvements on land are not possible. Capital formation in agriculture suffers and the economy is bogged down to the subsistence level. The problem of feeding growing population becomes serious due to acute shortage of food products. These have to be imported, which raises the balance of payments difficulties. Thus, the growth of population retards agricultural development. Fourth, capital formation. Growth of population retards capital formation. As population increases, per capita available income declines. People are required to feed more children with same income. It means more expenditure on consumption and a further fall in already low savings and consequently in the level of investment. Further, a rapidly growing population by losing income, savings and investment compels the people to use a low level of technology, which further retards capital formation. Fifth, employment. A rapidly increasing population plunges the economy into mass unemployment and underemployment. As population increases, the proportion of workers to total population rises, but in the absence of complementary resources, it is not possible to expand jobs. The result is that with the rise in labor force, unemployment and underemployment increases. A rapidly increasing population reduces income, savings, and investment. Thus, capital formation is retarded and job opportunities are reduced, thereby increasing unemployment. Moreover, as the labor force increases in relation to land, capital, and other resources, complementary factors available per worker decline. As a result, unemployment increases. India has a backlog of unemployment, which keeps on growing with a rapidly increasing population. It tends to increase the level of unemployment and manifold as compared with actual increase in labor force. Sixth, environment. Rapid population growth leads to environmental damage. Scarcity of land due to rapidly increasing population pushes large number of people to ecologically sensitive areas such as hillsides and tropical forests. It leads to overgrazing and cutting of forest for cultivation, leading to severe environmental damage. Moreover, the pressure of rapid growth of population forces people to obtain more food for themselves and their livestock. And as a result, they over-cultivate the semi-arid areas. This leads to desertification over the long run, where the land stops yielding anything. Besides, rapidly population growth leads to migration of large number of to urban areas, with industrialization. This results in severe air, water, and noise pollution in cities and towns. And finally, seventh, social infrastructure. Rapidly growing population necessitates large investments in social infrastructure and diverts resources from directly productive assets. Due to scarcity of resources, it's not possible to provide educational, health, medical, transport, and housing facilities to the entire population. There is overcrowding everywhere. As a result, the quality of the services goes down. To provide this social infrastructure requires huge investments. So this was all from my side. Thank you.